Pembroke Fire Department held a small media event to showcase the acquisition of a new pumper truck that will be replacing the current pumper truck, which just happens to be a 1992 model. The new truck, costing about $590,000, will be a key part ensuring the frontline apparatuses are up to standards, and with a key addition of an 800-gallon tank, this truck will be allowed to immediately start fire suppression once on a site rather than finding a hydrant upon arrival to an incident. Fire Chief Dan Herbach has more.
The oldest truck is the 1992. The 1992 pumper is the one that's going to go out of service once we have this truck in service. The 2006 is our truck that was frontline pumper, and this one will replace it. That's a pumper. We have the 2013 Ariel. And of course, you know the Ariel. You've got a lot of video of the Ariel at fires. That's a 2013 Pierce Ariel that came from the same company as this truck. And now we have the 2018 Pierce pumper. Like I said, the 1992 will go out of service as soon as we have this one in service. Part of the contract to purchase this truck is that they have to train us on its use. And so next week is when our training orientation is, and the firefighters will all get their training, and then we'll put it into service after that. It means a lot to be able to carry the 800 gallons and be able to respond immediately without even having to grab a hydrant yet and have our secondary crews come in and do things like that, which is the way that we always work. But this really is just a need for a truck that was needed to be replaced in age and being replaced by a much newer and safer truck.
Starting a number of years ago, the city began putting away money each year to create a reserve for replacement fire department apparatuses and equipment, which comes in handy when they need to replace such things as a new truck. No money from the current budget has been affected with the purchase of this fire truck.
And the reserves are put away for potential purchases for something that you may require in the future. For us, it's considered the apparatus or equipment replacement reserve. So what we've done is we've come up with a number through our figures of all the equipment that we have, including our apparatus, and the money's put away to ensure that when the time comes to buy a new apparatus or some equipment, that the money is in reserve, and we don't have to say to council, we don't know where the money's going to come from, but we need this. So, and council, like I said, it's council that agreed to go ahead with this and ensure that the money is always available in reserves.
As for what will happen to the 1992 pumper, Herbach says he has seen in some cases those trucks are sold to overseas and used. Some fire standards are just not as strict as Canadian fire standards. Reporting for Cogeco News, I'm Trevor Riley.